Welcome to GC Ready Technologies. Introduction to Eclipse IDE. Eclipse IDE was released in 2001 by Eclipse Foundation and it supports Microsoft Windows, Linux, Solaris and Mac environments for software development. Programming. Say, you can download Eclipse IDE from eclipse.org. It is freeware. Just a minute. After downloading, you can get this Eclipse IDE. See, I downloaded Eclipse IDE for Java and for Windows environment. See, Eclipse IDE supports Eclipse IDE in an integrated development environment for developing applications, software applications using Java programming language and other programming languages such as C, C++, Python, PERL, PHP, Ruby, etc. Say, Eclipse IDE has several plugins. Using those plugins, we can write and execute different types of programs. I downloaded Eclipse IDE for Java and it is for Windows 64-bit environment. It is cross-platform. It supports Microsoft Windows, Linux, Solaris and Macintosh operating environments. And it supports writing Java programs and other plugins also available. You can download Eclipse IDE for Python programming, that plugin. Eclipse IDE for PERL plugin, PERL programming. Next, Eclipse IDE for PHP, etc. I downloaded Eclipse IDE for Java programming on Windows 64-bit environment. It is free software. See, after downloading Eclipse IDE, you can you no need to install, just extract that one, extract the software. See, extract files. I extract it to desktop. After extraction, you can get this Eclipse folder. In this folder, some subfolders available and some files also available. Observe this symbol, Eclipse application file. This is Eclipse IDE launcher. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. See, Eclipse IDE, we have different versions, Photon, Luna, Photon, Luna, like different versions. I downloaded Photon. Different flavors of IDE available. Anyhow, it is freeware. See, once again, Eclipse IDE, it is showing workspace folder. When you launch Eclipse IDE for first time in your computer, it will show this one. If you don't want this folder, you can use another folder. It is default folder. When you launch Eclipse IDE from your computer for first time, it will show this path. It will create that workspace folder. What is the workspace folder? Say, if you write computer programs, then those programs will be saved in this workspace folder of your hard disk. Suppose I want to develop Java programs. For that, first you need to install Java software. Download and install Java software. I downloaded and just a minute. I downloaded and installed Java software. After installation, I can get this Java folder in program files. Next, set Java environment variable path in your computer in order to access Java software from any directory in your machine. First, download and install Java software JDK, Java Development Kit. Next, set Java environment variable path. After that, download Eclipse IDE for Java developers for your operating system compatible software. Mine is Windows 10 64-bit operating system. That's why I downloaded Windows 10 on 10.7 same software. Here difference is 32-bit or 64-bit. Just a minute. Eclipse IDE download. Eclipse IDE download. It is open source, freeware. Here observe right side. For Windows 32, Windows 64-bit. That operating system compatible software. It is cross-platform. But you need to download your operating system compatible software. Suppose yours is Windows 32-bit, download Windows 32-bit Eclipse IDE. Next, Windows 64-bit compatible Eclipse IDE. Here, Eclipse IDE, next operating environment, next programming, our programming is Java. Next, operating system is Windows 32-bit. Otherwise, Mac OS, Linux 32, Linux 64 available. Suppose, if you want others, observe. Just a minute. If you want other packages, here observe. Eclipse IDE for C++ developers, Windows 64-bit, Mac 64, Linux 64. Next, Eclipse IDE for Java developers, Eclipse IDE for PHP developers, like this. See, Eclipse IDE was launched in 2001 by Eclipse Foundation, and it supports various operating environment like Microsoft Windows, Linux, Solaris, and Macintosh. Eclipse platform and other plugins from the Eclipse Foundation is released under the Eclipse Public License, EPL. It is free to use. And also Eclipse to be modified and distributed to others. Eclipse is an integrated development environment. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. Eclipse IDE for developing applications using the Java programming language and other programming languages such as C++, Python, PERL, PHP, Ruby, etc. Eclipse can be used as an IDE for any programming language for which a plugin is available. You can also write code in a text editor like Notepad. You can also write your code in a text editor like Notepad and compile and execute from command line. But compared to a text editor, Eclipse provides many additional features to make the development of software easier and faster. Observe, click launch. See, you can write Java or any other language programs in a text editor like Notepad. Next, compile. After compilation, you can execute that program from command line, but no syntax guidance, no auto compilation, no context help. If we use Eclipse IDE, it will provide editor for writing your programs. Next, syntax guidance, context help, and auto compilation. See, in computer programming, we have three steps. One is write a program in any editor. Suppose Notepad is editor. Write a program in any editor. That is first step. Second step, compile the program. Compiling high level language into machine level language. Say we use high level language in our programs. For, if, do, while, all are English words. Computer can't understand these high level language, these words belongs to high level language. We have to convert high level language into machine level language, binary language. Next, execute the program. Write a program, compile the program, and execute the program. If you use Eclipse IDE, it provides editor for writing program. See, this Eclipse IDE for writing Java programs. Just a minute. This Eclipse IDE for writing Java programs. Suppose I am deleting this one. It is for writing Java programs. Continue. Save file. Java project. Next, suppose project name. Project 1. Finish. Next, create a package under this project. We can create multiple packages in a project. Suppose package 1. It is not taking. Suppose XYZA. Finish. Oh, package 1, package 2 already there. Oh, it is old one. I already created this project. See, file, new, Java project. That project information already available in my hard disk workspace. Suppose sample. Sample project, it is new. Finish. Next, select project and create a package. Next, sample package. See, under a project we can create multiple packages. Under a package we can create multiple classes, Java classes. Suppose sample program. See, generate main method. See, observe. It is providing editor for writing programs. Suppose I am writing one small program. Int a equals to 100. I am following Java syntax. Suppose int a equals to 1.2. Just a minute. It's taking time. Why? 1.2. Now observe error, syntax error. It is providing syntax guidance. If it is Notepad, it won't provide syntax guidance. See, syntax guidance. See, change A to double data type. otherwise add cache to int. Say if you create integer variable, then we can assign integer type data only. Next, int b equals to 200. Next, SYSO control space. Observe, this is context help a plus b. See, if you run the program, no need to compile. If it is notepad, you need to compile the program. But if you are using Eclipse IDE, you no need to compile the program. Auto compilation, write a program and run the program. You can get output on the Eclipse IDE console. Okay, this is about Eclipse IDE. It is freeware. It supports various plugins to write computer programs like C++, PERL, Python. Actually, initially it is developed for Java. You need to download your programming specific and your operating environment compatible software. Then you can write and execute your programs. And one more thing, if you use Eclipse IDE, you can get some more advantages. You can integrate software. Suppose I installed Java in my machine and I'm using Eclipse IDE for Java programming. After that, suppose if I want to integrate Selenium WebDriver for this Java, I can integrate. Suppose Maven is built-in plugin, you can integrate Maven. Next, suppose if you want to use any testing framework like JUnit or TestNG, you can install that just a minute. You can install that software and you can integrate with our Java. So in Eclipse IDE, benefits are it provides editor for writing programs, syntax guidance, context help, auto compilation, and you can integrate software. Okay, thank you.